One day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know?
And getting that call. Can you imagine it being your son, your daughter, in the confines of an elementary school where there are children playing and having fun and having to receive that kind of information? So we want to make sure that we continue praying for the families that lost those loved ones, but then even more specifically, for the children that were there and saw it. You know, for a child to see that kind of thing is amazing. For us adults, we couldn't take it. But imagine the mind of a child who doesn't understand what just happened. And then pray for our children. Amen. It makes you appreciate what you have now, don't you? They may be bad, but they're yours. And they're still here, amen. So stand with me today. Turn to Micah. It's the Bible, book of the Bible. We don't use that often. So make sure you look in the table of contents to find it. Amen. Micah. Chapter 5. Starting at verse 2. Amen. Amen. You still looking for it? Say, hold on, amen.
Hold on.
Amen, Micah. Daniel, Hosea, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, then comes Micah. Amen. If you're still looking for it, we're going to pray for you. Amen. Amen. Micah chapter 5, verse 2. Pray everyone would stand for the reading of the word. Amen. It says these words: But thou, Bethlehem, Ephratah, though thou be little among thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall come forth unto me that is to be ruler in Israel, whose goings forth have been from of old, from everlasting. Therefore will he give them up unto the time that she which travaileth hath brought forth. Then the remnant of his brother shall return unto the children of Israel. And he shall stand and feed in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord, his God, and they shall abide. For now shall he be great unto the ends of the earth. Amen. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. Amen. I want to preach from the subject today: small packages. Small packages. As a child, I can recall during the time of Christmas, looking under Christmas tree. And though there may have been many gifts under the tree, I would look for the biggest package I could find, hoping it was mine. Looking under the tree and moving past all the small packages and looking for the big package, hoping that the big one was mine. But you know what you come to find out is sometimes the greatest gift doesn't come in the biggest package. the gift that you treasure the most doesn't always come in the biggest package. But sometimes it comes in small packages. And people of God, I've come here today to advise us that sometimes we look past the greatest gift that you have, looking for something bigger. Sometimes we praise God for the big things in life. We praise God for our houses and cars. We praise God for our jobs. We praise God for the little money you got in the bank. But what I've come to tell you today is the enemy does not care about your house. The enemy does not care about your car, has no concern about your money. But what the enemy is after is your small package. For you got to recognize that the enemy knows that though you are planted and rooted in what you're going to be, you believe in God, you know what God can do. There's no turning you away from God. You're already confident in who you are. Amen. God gave us some small packages. And so every time we look at the gift of children, you can't look past it. Because in that small package, God has placed everything inside of it. Understand, God uses a seed, which is small. But don't you know that when we look at a seed, when you look at a seed literally, physically, when you look at a seed, understand that a seed is simply a suppressed tree. It is a tree that has been suppressed and is waiting to grow and to sprout and to show what the tree is made of. The seed is full of promise, possibility, and purpose. And so what the enemy will do is the enemy knows that though I can't take the tree, I can stop the seed. So we've got to be cautiously careful that we don't take for granted the small package that God has given us. Because it is the greatest gift that you can have. Full of purpose, promise, and purpose. And purpose, promise, and here it is. And it has something that it has to do. Watch this. What is now that the Bible says in Micah chapter 5. The Bible now in Micah encourages Bethlehem. Can I share this with you? The Bible in Micah chapter 5 verse 2 encourages Bethlehem. The word Bethlehem really simply means small town. It says, small town, though you are small in size, there's going to be something great that comes out of you. The Bible says to the small town, though you're small in size in comparison to those cities like Judah that has thousands of people, he says that there's going to be one that's going to come from among you that's going to be ruler. Can I share this with you? So now, in the midst of a small town, there's some big purpose. And just like God knows that there's some good things that can come out of small packages, so does the devil. And can you believe that every time God gets ready to do something, he starts with the seed in small places. And as God starts with the seed in small places, every time God gets ready to do something new, the enemy does all he can to stop it. Remember in the Bible days in Genesis, as God now sends the deliverer whose name is Moses. And as God is about to deliver Moses, it says that then Pharaoh launches an attack, here it is, on every seed. Because I understand that the deliverer is here. So I'm going to stop it before it starts. Y'all gonna follow me? And so even now, as we see that though Pharaoh started the killing spree of all the children, God has a way of protecting the one he's going to use. And though you thought you had me, God has allowed me to escape. And so now we find, as we look at the story of Christmas, you can't talk about Christmas without talking about the seed. So God now sends the one that's going to be the ruler, that is going to be the deliverer, not just of some people, but of all people. And God says, I'm going to send him in a way they don't expect. They were looking for the Messiah to come in a big way. But God said, I'm going to put him in a seat. Y'all got to see this. And though you're looking for big packages, I'm going to put him in a small town named Bethlehem. And so now God sends Jesus through the woman to be the seed of Abraham. Now watch this. As he is being born, we'll talk about next week how God sends the star to let the wise men know where to go. As the wise men look for the star and follow the star to get to the manger, it says that when they come back to him, then they go back. And God says, watch this. You can't tell what you know because Herod is going to try to kill him. Now, I need you to go with me. You got to go to Matthew. If you go to Matthew chapter 2, verse 16, watch this. Matthew chapter 2, verse 16 says, then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men, was exceeding wroth, and sent forth, and listen to this, and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem, and in all of the coasts thereof, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the wise man. That then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, saying, in Ramah was there a voice heard, lamentation, weeping, and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children, and would not be comforted because they are not there. Listen to this. Isn't it amazing how days before we celebrate Jesus, in a small town, there's a killing of children. Y'all can see this. You can't think it's just coincidence. Before we celebrate the birth of the one that came to save us, in a small town, there's some killing of children. None of them over 6 years old. And all over the land, there's weeping and lamentation. People are hurting all over. People are looking for answers. Listen to this. But God sent me here to tell you that it's all about the seed. He didn't just kill children. He killed possibility. He killed potential. And he killed promise. Sometimes you can't discount the package. They said, listen to this, they said, nothing like this ever happened in our time. But sometimes God will take a small town to show you who he really is. Isn't it amazing now that the devil tried to take the seed? Listen, can I help us with our homework? Stop saying that there was something mentally wrong with this man. Stop saying that there was something that his mother could have done. Stop saying that Obama could have controlled guns. Can I tell the nation something? I don't care what you think you control. As long as the enemy is running rampant, anything can happen. It doesn't matter if you can say, watch this. Sometimes we say, well, if they had not taken prayer out of school, then that wouldn't happen. But listen to this. In the same week, in less than 2 or 3 days, you've seen God, you've seen the enemy work in the school. We've seen right here in Birmingham, the enemy work in the hospital. In the courthouse. And we've even seen this year some things happen in the Lord's house. So understand, this is not about mental capacity. This has nothing to do with the ability to think rationally. This has nothing to do with upbringing, but it's all. Because the enemy said that I have come to kill, steal, and destroy. So listen to what my problem is. The problem I have is that the enemy is doing his job. The problem I have is, why aren't we doing ours? We got to make sure that in the midst of us looking for our house, looking for our car, we don't forget the small package. We don't lose sight of what is really going on around us. Stop saying there's nothing we can do with our children, because at some point in your life, somebody felt the same way about you. I ought to have some witnesses in the house. Everybody in the house used to be something else when you were a small package. But aren't you glad that God is able to spring some stuff out of you? That God is able to birth some things out of you? God didn't allow you to remain where you are, but God made a way of escape for you? God knew Herod was going to look for him. So he tells Joseph, get you and your baby out of Bethlehem and send them over to Egypt. Because there's some stuff that's going to go on right where you are. And I've come to encourage somebody in the house. You don't know why you did what you did, but aren't you glad that God allowed you to move just in the nick of time? Aren't you glad that there were some things that were set up to destroy you, but God told you to go the other way? I don't know who I'm talking to in the house, but there's somebody in the house. You should have been dead a long time ago, but God made you take a detour. God changed your direction, and now you're still here. And I've come to ask, is there anybody in the house that can praise God for small packages? It is within the small package that gives birth to promise. What did he kill? He killed the next person that could have cured some disease. He took the life of somebody that was going to be able to make some things happen that have never been seen before. He destroyed promise. Somebody was going to be the first one in their family to graduate. And the devil knows. So he tries to stop the seed before it gets planted. I need to encourage all of us. Don't take your seed for granted. Amen. That's why the old folks used to say, I don't care what you do, you're going to church. Amen. Because they knew if I don't plant the seed, I may lose the seed. All right. I believe you talked about before the parable of the sower. How sometimes when you throw the seed, it may land on rough ground. And there's some of us, here it is, we didn't come up the way everybody else came up. You had a rough upbringing. You had to go through some rough stuff. But here it is. But God will allow you to grow wherever you are. Even in some unlikely places. There were some places, here it is, that people told you you would never make it out of. But look at you now. And I ought to have a witness in the house that knows that life for you ain't been no crystal sayers. You had some thorns in your side. You had some things that you had to go through. But God kept me through it all. Sometimes the enemy will do something drastic to take your eyes off of what's really important. Days before we praise God for the birth of Jesus, the enemy takes the focus off of God. So now instead of praising God, people are questioning God. How could God let something like this happen? If God is so good, why did he allow this tragedy to happen? And so instead of celebrating Christmas, people are mourning. Because he took the seed. But if nothing else, when you look at the fact, it could have been me. It could have been mine. It could have been you that got that call on your job. But now that God has given you another chance, and now that God has given you another opportunity, here it is, don't take your seed for granted. Listen to this. You got to make sure that you plant your seed. Why do you have to plant them? You got to make sure your seed is in good ground. Make sure you don't leave your seed at the house while you come to God's house. You got to nurture your seed. Listen to this. You got to water your seed. Stop telling your seed what they're not going to be. Because here it is. You kill them quicker than that AK-47 could. But you got to water your seed. You got to make sure they know that God's got greatness inside of them. They are children of promise. They are children of purpose. And I don't care what the situation may be, God still has his hand on your life. Listen to this. Now when you look at your seed, you see them totally different. Because when I see the faces of those parents, you can't imagine the hurt. But think about how God feels. You took little angels that had no opportunity to be who they were called to be out of my hands. But every day, we take it for granted. You wake up and you leave your children and you send them off to school without even praying for them. But there was a time in the Bible where the death angel was sweeping across the land and they were taking all the children, and the people of God knew that we had to put the blood over our house. And I wonder, is there anybody in the house that knows even now, you can't keep talking about gun control, but we need to plead the blood. You can't keep talking about who needs to be in the hospital, but we need the blood of Christ over our children. Is there anybody in the house that knows, if it not been for the blood of Jesus that covered us, you got to speak the blood. You got to, I wish I had some folks in the house that remember how it was in the old days. You plead the blood over your house, no matter what the enemy may try. You can't have my children. You cannot destroy my children. As a matter of fact, when they go to school, the school will be protected because I'm pleading the blood over my children. They may have taken prayer out of the school, but they can't keep God off the school. Is there anybody in the house that knows God is still able? This young 20-year-old man made a decision to allow the enemy to use him to destroy seeds. But now if he can decide to destroy the seed, can we decide to plant some seeds? Can we make a decision right now that as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord? Can we make a decision right now that God, I'm covering my children. I'm praying that my children will be the head, not the tail. They will be above and not beneath. They will make it. They will be successful. They will grow up to give you glory. Now more than ever, I don't have any physical children, but I'm praying for your children. I don't see how you can go through all that and not bring your children to church today. I don't care how you bring them. Amen. But you got to plant your seed. Yes, Lord. In good ground. Yes. Watch this. He says, because my seed is going to be the ruler.
All right.
And watch this. He's going to bring forth the nation. Yes. Can you believe that God will put something in you that's going to bless the world? Yes, I don't have any witnesses in the house. That's all right. I'm believing for your children, even you don't. God put something in you. He allowed you to give birth to a seed. You don't see it now because it's a small package. But when God starts opening up your seed, when God starts revealing what they're going to be, when God starts doing what he knows he's going to do, eyes have not seen. I wish I had some help. Ears haven't heard. It hasn't even been imagined what your seed is going to do. Now, is there anybody in the house that can help me praise God for your seed? Can you praise God for your package? It may not be what you have wanted, but God gave it to you. This will be a sign unto you that there's going to be weeping and lamentation. But on the other side of weeping, if you read your Bible, the Bible says that weeping only endures. I wish I had some help in the house. It only endures for the night. But I don't care what the world may say. I still got to celebrate the fact that God sent his son. was a small package. Aren't you glad that joy came in the morning? And is there anybody in the house that can give God glory, even right now? Even on this Christmas season, can you give God glory that it was through the seed of Mary that God brought forth his only begotten son? Aren't you glad in the house that though the devil tried to stop him, God wouldn't let him touch him? God made a way out of no way. Won't God make a way of escape? Aren't you glad God kept your children? When you weren't around them, God kept a hedge of protection all around them. Aren't you glad that God keeps your seed from dangerous seed and unseen? Aren't you glad that God made a way that no matter what the enemy came to do, he had to fall at his feet? You ought to praise God that no weapon that's formed against me shall prosper in the name of Jesus. You can do what you want, but my seed gonna be covered. You can try to kill him, but my seed gonna be covered. I plead the blood over our children. I'm calling the name of Jesus. No matter what, God protected them. Jesus be a witness all around them. Every day in the schoolhouse, in your house, you want to praise God that he will be a witness. Won't he work it out? Won't he protect you? Won't he lead him? Won't he guide him? You want to give God glory. Listen to this. You keep saying, I'm glad it wasn't mine. When you should be saying, God, it could have been. There were some Christians in that school. It could have been you. There were some people in that school. It could have been yours. But God said, I'm giving you a wake-up call. You can't give up on your child just because the package don't look like you want it to. The baby is wrapped in swaddling clothes. Scraps. Your child may not have all that you think it should. But excuse the wrapping. Your child may not have come from the father you thought they should or the mother you think they should, but excuse the wrapping. Because God gave me my package. Can anybody say he gave it to me? He thought enough of you to give you a gift. And you can't take that gift for granted. Even now.